We have an amazing episode for you today, but first I want to tell you about Anchor, the easiest way to make a podcast. Whether it's recording new podcast episodes, uploading existing episodes, editing, or more, Anchor gives you everything you need in one place to create your podcast from your computer or your phone and make it sound amazing. And the best part? It's free. Yes, Anchor is completely free. Anchor makes it easy to make money with a podcast without a minimum listenership, and will even distribute your podcast so it can be heard anywhere from Spotify, Apple Podcast, Google Podcast, and more. The podcast process has been so easy because of Anchor, and I couldn't have asked for a better experience right off the bat. I'm recommending Anchor to all of my listeners who are wanting to start a podcast. Be sure to download the Anchor app or go to anchor.fm to get started building your own podcast today. My name is Kristen Kubik, and you're listening to As Told Unfiltered, the podcast that dives deep into what it's really like running a business. The raw, the real, and the completely unfiltered. Hello, beautiful people. Welcome back to the 12 Days of Podmas. If you're new here, welcome to the podcast. I'm your hostess with the mostest Red Bull in the state of Maryland, Kristen Kubik. I really feel like Red Bull should just give me a sponsorship at this point. What do you guys think? Each day, I'm giving you nuggets of golden information about entrepreneurship, mindset, and all-around business. Today's topic is you. More importantly, your vibe and what you're attracting, who you're attracting. There's this quote that floats around that says, your vibe attracts your tribe. And first of all, I'm just going to acknowledge the cultural appropriation that's been taken from the term tribe, because I fully think white people need to stop using the word tribe. And don't come at me if you feel differently, because I really don't care. It's rude, and I'm really loud when it comes to being anti-racist. But second, your vibe attracts so much more than just the people around you, and that's something nobody really talks about. Your vibe attracts legitimately everything. Now, I'm a firm believer in manifestation. I could do a whole episode on that itself. I'm a firm believer in the law of attraction. I'm a firm believer that what you put out into the universe is what you'll get back, and that karmic debt is real. I'm sure you're sitting there like, cool, but how does this work in my business? Simmer down, Cindy. The question you should be asking yourself is, how doesn't it work in your business? Your content is a great place to start. When you create your content, you're creating from you. You are screaming through your content, whether you realize it or not. Your energy, your vibe, your everything, it's all in your content. And people, specifically your audience, can see that. They can feel it. They can feel your anger. They can feel your annoyance. They can feel your happiness. They can feel your love. And they can even feel your legitimate desire to make that impact, or your fake desire that only cares about the money. Your content is what's attracting your audience. It's what's attracting your ideal client. But are you actually writing for your ideal client? Or are you writing from a different place? Are you writing from, say, anger and annoyance when your ideal client is happy, bubbly, and fun with carefree lifestyle? And I know this from, experience, because I've done that. A big reason our content can fail is because we're taught to repurpose it. Repurposing is such an easy thing to do. It's a time saver. It's such a no-brainer, right? Wrong. And hear me out. Repurposing content doesn't work sometimes, and it's something nobody really talks about. If you're just copying and pasting the same post from a year or two ago, you shouldn't have the same energy. Your an always growing and ever-evolving human being. We're always changing. So what worked for us a year or two ago isn't necessarily what's going to work for us now. You can even go listen to probably a podcast episode from a year ago, and you can see that my podcast episodes don't work for me now necessarily. And that's okay. So what does that mean? Does it mean you can't repurpose your content? Definitely not. It just means you should look over it and rewrite it to just fit you now. Tweak some of it. It just means that your wording then may not fit the way you speak now, to who you're trying to call in as a client now. My ideal client was so different last year, even in the beginning of this year of 2020, than it is at the end of this year, at the end of 2020. Which means my content is so different now than it was months ago, much less a year ago. I actually shared a memory from this time last year on Facebook, and the way I was writing then was, it was so, not necessarily harsh, but it was so in your face, and every other word was a curse word, and, you know, that's just the way I was speaking, and I'm still like that a lot of the time, but it's not necessarily as in your face, I should say, and it's not necessarily, you know, what I'm going for, and that's okay. Here's a secret. I still repurpose some of my content. I just happen to rewrite it to fit more of my style now. And it doesn't take long. I'm not spending hours on it. I'm not even spending more than a couple of minutes usually. I can add to or take away some things, especially that angry tone that tended to pop up, the annoyance, the want for small business owners to get their shit together when they're running their Etsy shops without even understanding if they should file their taxes or not. But now I can write about, or even talk about, mindset, how you affect your business, and, well, topics like this. All because who I'm attracting is just so different. And that's what the goal is. Our goal is always to move to the next level, like playing a video game. Which, in case you didn't know, happens to be one of my favorite pastimes lately. I'm a huge Call of Duty fan. The problem with using old content is that it can be you're calling in the same old client, the same old vibe. When in reality, you want to bring in a new client. Maybe you're looking to raise your prices, so you want higher paying clients. Maybe you're looking to create a whole new product line, so you're looking for completely different clients. Maybe you're looking to expand your group, but your group is filled with people who seek free coaching or heavy discounts. The goal is to expand. This seems to be a theme in what I've been talking about. And when we expand, our vibe does too. Our energy expands with us. So our content ends up expanding as well. And when we write from a place of where we are now, rather than using where we were back in that old energy, it's much easier to feel into that place. And that's when we get what we're looking for. Another way to think of this is photos. Our vibe can change so much in our photos, which is why it's fun to update photos all the time, whether it's doing a brand photo shoot, or if you're like me, just taking a tripod out and taking a ton of photos on your phone constantly. I mean, almost any time I have my makeup done. It's that fun to me. And it's that important that I consistently have photos that scream my now energy, rather than constantly using past photos. This also comes down to repurposing content. You're no longer who you were in those photos, so why would you still use them all the time? You like them. You feel pretty in them. You paid good money for them. Yay, I totally get it. Those are great reasons. But do you embody that same energy? Are you that same person? Did you feel the same way in that time frame that you do now? Your vibe attracts everything, not just people. It attracts engagement, it attracts money, it attracts abundance, it attracts energy, it attracts manifestations. You want to grow your business. You want to know why you aren't attracting that new audience. You want to finally figure out why you're not growing your engagement or bringing in those new clients. Then it's time to ditch the energy of the past. It's time to feel into that energy of now, the present. Who you are now is your vibe. And your vibe is going to bring in those people who you're meant to bring in. Who is meant to see your content will always see it. Are you repurposing your content? Do you find yourself leaning into the old energy by copying, pasting? Or do you tend to rewrite it to fit you in the now? Let me know on Instagram, at KristenUnfiltered. Check out today's show notes on the blog, kristencubic.com/astoldunfiltered. And thank you for listening to another episode of As Told Unfiltered. See you tomorrow for another episode of 12 Days of Podmas. Thank you so much for listening to today's episode. I just wanted to let you know that all of the listeners for As Told Unfiltered get a special offer, especially if you listen to the end because you're amazing. $100 off my signature digital course, Automation Queen to Sales Machine, that's going to help you streamline and automate your business so that you can spend less time making more sales. Use code Unfiltered. Go to kristencubic.com/astoldunfiltered for more information. See ya!